I'm a brother, you know, Allah forbid, you know. Imagine you have a disease, yes? And this disease is about to kill you. Someone come and remove that disease. How would you be grateful to this person?
Allah.
Say, what about the one who gave you the life for free?
I should be even more.
You see what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying. So we know that you should be, okay? We should be more grateful to the Creator. But now, what is the correct way to be grateful to Him? That's why you need what?
Prophets and messengers.
But again, many people claim to be prophets and messengers, and they're not a true prophets and messengers. And I was telling that to your friends who were last time, I said, look, how, as a Muslims, we don't just believe Prophet Muhammad and the Quran to be truth because you are born Muslims. So I'm saying, rather because you have a tangible proof that we can share it for everyone. For example, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam been prophesied about him in the Old Testament, in Isaiah 42. You see what I'm saying? Clearly, name Kedah, which is the son of Ishmael, Sela, the mountain in Medina. The other thing is, well, how Prophet Muhammad knew about the future?
That's something that does. It's something that it's incredible, to be honest with you.
Yeah. It's not just randomly, precisely. For example, and let's make, there is about the Arab they also competing.
The buildings and
there also the other one, which is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it will be.
He described embryology.
Yes, in the Quran.
Yeah.
About embryology, sahih. But the other one I was going to mention that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, will come a time when you see women dressed but naked at the same time. When you look, think about it, dressed but naked at the same time. It doesn't make any sense, but that's what's happening now.
It does.
You see what I'm saying? It does make sense.
It does.
You see what I'm saying? Another one, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, will come a time when the Muslim, they will take over Constantinople.
Turkey.
And that the Muslim, they took over Constantinople 800 years after passed away. And I'll give you another one, which one of the scholars mentioned it. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it will come a time when the Arabs, the Bedouin Arabs, they will stop using camels. And they will use something as a box. Bro, you tell me, if they don't use it, the Arabs, you know they call the camel, they call it the ante. They love it too much.
Oh, okay.
They always use it.
Oh, okay, okay.
You know what I mean? The ante, yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm saying, if they don't use a camel, they must use something else. And the Prophet Muhammad described it. And even he goes in details, he say they will place these books outside the mosque and wait for their family. This narration, one of the Muslim scholars said, this narration is too powerful because this narration describes exactly what is happening now. The Muslim comes with a car, drop his family, sometimes his family, meaning his wives or his daughters, they're not dressing correctly and go to the mosque. That's what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. How we knew that? That's why you know what? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ أَوْ رَسَلْتِ الْإِنْجُشَ وَمْ تَيْنِ الْإِنْجُشَ In Arabic. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ ثُمَّ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا إِنَّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُنْتَقِمُونَ Who is more unjust than the one who has been reminded with Allah's signs, the statute of Allah's signs, universal signs, and what? The legislative signs. Legislative signs, Prophet Muhammad prophecy, the miracles of the Quran, and he turns away from it. Allah indeed will take our revenge from people like that. That's why you know, look, what's your name again, sir?
Bo,
look, we believe that Allah is the most merciful, but also Allah is the most just. Allah said in the Quran, أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ Are we going to make those who are righteous equal to the evildoers? مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَ تَحْكُمُونَ How can you judge? You see what I'm saying? That's why based upon Allah's mercy, He creates paradise. And based upon Allah's anger, He creates what? Jahannam. However, Allah will judge everyone according to his good deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِضَلَّامِ الْعَبِيدِ Excuse me, can you move aside? If you don't mind. Thank you very much. Yeah, she's married, Marida. Yeah. So, okay. So Allah will not oppress his servants. But Allah said, وَلَكِنَّا People oppress themselves. By what? Leaving the universal signs and turning away from the Creator. Like I told you, if someone come and remove a disease that is about to kill you, you'll be very grateful to him. What about the one who gave you that life? You'll be more grateful to him. So why don't you be grateful to him?
I mean, I think I am. But obviously, like you said, how do you know it's in the right
correct way?
Yeah.
Because why? Remember, you and I, excuse me, you know what? You can't be standing next to me, laughing next to my ears.
I know.
She knows.
Yeah, she's nowhere. Yeah. She's like, yeah, go on, you want to ask me something? Go on.
I was just going to ask you, true that, like, I heard someone else say it, so I don't know.
No. I'll tell you, bro. Feel free to ask me questions.
Sure. Go on. But is it true that if you have, like, a seed within you that believes in Allah, you can be accepted?
Yes. The seed, but what is the seed? The seed that La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. You believe in Allah correctly. There's narration that the Messenger of Allah said, you know, some Muslims, they do like evil things. Some of them will be punished. However, they will not be in Jahannam forever. They have fire forever. Because they have something which is the greatest thing. Which is what? To testify there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. And to testify Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah. You see what I'm saying? That's what, something good in you. You already believe in the first part. But the second part, I'm saying, look, let's establish something, bro. If someone comes to you now, and establishes a doctor, but I always mention this, Allah forbid, yeah? Imagine a doctor comes to us now, and he say, you know, bro, I know the disease that you have. And he say, you know what, except you're a doctor. Logic dictate what? You follow his advice. You see what I'm saying? Otherwise, if you say, no, I'm not going to follow your advice, you're contradicting yourself. So logically speaking, if we establish Prophet Muhammad as a true prophet, logic dictates what? Believe he came with. See what I'm saying? That's why one of the criteria for the true prophet, he must be what? One known to be a good person, not a liar. Why? Because imagine, Bo, there's a person, you and I, we know he's a liar, big liar. And he comes to us and he says, you know what, I'm a prophet of God. Would you accept him?
No.
You cannot. You can get worse, bro. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's why, look, that's one of the criteria. The prophets of God, Moses, Jesus, Abraham, Noah, Jacob, Isaac, all of them, historically speaking, were known to be true prophets. Good people, and to be what? Honest people, and trustworthy people. That's the second one, they come with prophecies. The third one, they come with the same message. Even though they never met each other while they were preaching. That is a miracle. How Prophet Muhammad never met Jesus, and they came what? Worship the God of Abraham, the God of Adam. How Prophet Muhammad never met Abraham and he came with the same teaching, worship the God of Adam, worship the creator of the heavens and the heaven which is between them. And remember this life, bro, as I was saying, the brothers there, you're not ready, but death is ready for you. You know what I'm saying? If the truth, you know, if the truth is clear and it makes sense, forget about the people, it's about to accept and hug it. And I always advise the people that look, not like Islam is not like a cake, but imagine you want to eat a cake. If you eat all of it one time, what happened to you? You vomited.
Yeah.
In order for you to feel the sweetness of the cake, bit by bit.
Yeah.
Islam first, if the foundation is clear to you, as for the prayers, as for the other one, it's after. You know what I'm saying? As you know, we always, imagine I'll tell you, you know, wow, come to my house 5 times a day and I will give you £5,000. Every time you come, I'll give you £5,000. You freaking what?
You know, you're coming. Yeah.
Yeah. You'll be before time.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. Sure.
What about praying to your Creator? What is worshiping Him, which you already have? That let me be grateful to my Creator. The eyes that you have. Look, if people give you £10 million, you will never sell them. You see what I'm saying? The kidney that you have, the hands that you have, that's all Allah's blessings. That's what Allah always reminds the people with His blessings. That's what Allah said in the Quran, وَإِنْ تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you try to count Allah's blessings, you will never be able to do so. What do you think what I said to you so far? Does it make sense to you? Is it clear to you? I'm inviting you to become a Muslim.
Well, I think, like you said, little by little.
Yes.
And I think if you told me, like when you said last week, what's prevented you from
what is prevented you to become Muslim now?
Like I said, for me, I feel like if I turned around today and was like, that's it, you'd be like, well, you know, at the end of the day, anyone could have come to me and said something to me and given me, you know,
information
and I could take it and I could believe it. So for me, it's about learning.
You want to learn more.
And in myself, you know, I don't want to dive in because I'm
not
like, you know, how can I do that? That's not being fair myself.
Oh, yes. It's of course.
And I believe it's a journey.
Yes, without any doubt.
I believe it's a journey.
But I'm saying if the foundation is clear to you, then like for example, the first part, because what is a shahada ta'in? You know, when you become a Muslim, what is it? Is it to, the first one is I bear witness, there's no one worthy of worship except God, Allah. Which you have. I should appreciate my creator, Allah. Yes? And Allah is a term that is what? Is because now, let me ask you. In order for me to speak about someone's father, I have to get that information from his father or the son. The name Allah, the creator, told us his name. You see what I'm saying? Even Jesus never called God God. He didn't speak English, Jesus. You see what I'm saying? He spoke Aramaic or Syriac, it differ. He said Ilahi, which is similar to Arabic as Ilah. وإله except Allah. لا مين لكن هو yeah except Allah مين that's what I'm saying so except Allah why so because why here you have to specify the name okay Allah سبحانه وتعالى the God the creator of the heavens and the earth and the oceans between them he's the one who said my name is Allah okay that's the first part the second part that Muhammad to be a prophet of God and you already know some prophets of God some prophecies that Prophet Muhammad mentioned you see what I'm saying that's the thing as for to become a scholar in Islam because one of the deception of Satan he will tell you you know what don't become Muslim yet until you learn but that's one it's good to learn of course but I'm saying if the foundation is clear it's like you we want to go to uni if you establish that uni is a good uni as for knowing in details which room is A which room is B which room is this then come after you see what I'm saying that will not prevent you to go to the uni because you do not in details the rooms understand so I'm saying if that is clear bro I'm saying you should accept Islam man you know what I mean and that's the best gift because remember how many years you've been cut off from your creator And you know you should appreciate him.
Do you believe that like anyone that doesn't follow that is not Muslim is either on the path thing that they pray to at all?
Yes.
Do you believe that?
Yeah, 100%? Yeah. Because why? Otherwise, many people claim that they are worshiping the Creator.
Yeah.
That's why, based upon the Creator,
my friend, when he said about it's subjective.
It's subjective. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. That's why you know what is the beautiful things about the Creator that when Allah sent the prophets and messengers, He did not tell them, "Go say you are a prophet of God and that's it." Remember, they claim. That's why one of the scholars said. If someone claims to be a prophet of God, there's two things. He must be the most truthful person or the biggest liar ever existed. Because you are claiming to the Creator have sent you. Not the king or the police officer or your neighbor, the Creator. The highest, the biggest, the greatest. Yeah? So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the prophets and messengers, He gave them something that differentiated from the rest of the people. In order for you and me, when we look at it, to become clear to us, yes, they are prophets of God. Not subjective, objective. Like, I always mention this example. One of the miracles of the Quran, which Allah mentioned in the Quran 1400 years ago, Allah said, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُذَّكِرٍ We have made Quran easy to be memorized. And nowadays, I always ask this question, bro, maybe you have heard me before, I ask it to many people, is there any book that we know other than the Quran? Put the Quran aside. Is there any book that we know? It has been memorized by 100 million of people who doesn't know speak the language of the book. Do you know any book like that? Except like you and me and him, we memorize the book in Chinese, but we don't know nothing about Chinese language. Imagine, it doesn't happen. Except with the Quran. You go to China, you go to Pakistan, you go to Africa, you go to Europe. Children the age of 9, 10, 11 memorize the Quran chapter by chapter, word by word, letter by letter. They don't know the Arabic language. Sometimes even if they do know Arabic language, they will make mistakes in pronunciation. But when they recite the Quran, they will recite it perfectly. Why? Because when they speak in Arabic language, that is the word of human being. But when they recite the Quran, it's the word of Allah. Which Allah promised that will make it easy for people to memorize it. Bro, that is too much evidences, man, to turn away from it. I'm telling you, forget about the people. You're going to be inside the grave. I'm going to be inside the grave by ourselves. And we're going to meet our Creator. And that day, no one knows. You see what I'm saying? So, if the fact, that's what I'm saying, look, maybe if you can watch them, is because the Prophet said, if Allah guide one person through you, it's better than the world and what's in it. Wallahi, that is the clearest thing. That I worship my Creator, according to His Prophet, as I've mentioned many times, if I was alive at the time of Jesus, and I was in the Israelites, I would say there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and Jesus is the messenger of Allah. If I was alive at the time of Moses, I would say there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and Moses is the messenger of Allah, and that will save me. Now the last prophet is Muhammad. There is no salvation except by saying, there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and Muhammad the messenger of Allah. And look, there is a huge war against Islam. Everyone knows, the media line against Islam. They're always, you see what I'm saying, unbelievable. But yet, the fastest growing religion on the face of earth is Islam. And they say Islam oppress women. majority of people that accept Islam in Britain are women.
No, I refute any of the claims that people make. You know, it is all propaganda with the gender.
Proper. But you know what, Bao? Yeah, the question you ask yourself, yeah, how come even we know the Muslims are weak, but why people are accepting Islam? Because Allah said it in the Quran, and Prophet Muhammad said it. That's why if all mankind come together to try to prevent Islam, they will never be successful. Because why? They are fighting against the greatest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is clear, bro. And you should accept Islam, man. As for learning, step by step. If it's clear for you, the foundation, first part, which you believe in it. Second part, which is you know, prophecies that Prophet Muhammad said in the second place. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I have to.
I have to.
I mean, I've not read the Quran, so I have to read.
Yeah. I'll give you this one. Yeah, the man. Yeah.
Thank you.
This one, you know, to clarify in that has to do with highest everything.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Do you have any question you want to ask or something?
I mean, you've asked.
Don't ask me for money, I don't have no money. I'm joking.
Yeah, no, I'm probably going to do studying and then.
Inshallah. Take my number, yeah. If you have any inquiries or something, you can text me, WhatsApp me. Yeah, no worries at all, man.
إذا أعجبك الفيديو لا تنسى الإعجاب والتعليق، ولكي يصلك كل جديد اشترك الآن.